What's happening, people? We're back here once again on Cubcam TV for this another edition of Cub Reacts. First of all, I want to say a massive shout out to all the new subscribers. We've gone up nearly 700 in the last week or so. So thank you to each and every one of you getting involved with the channel. I can't thank you enough. I'm absolutely loving doing these reaction videos and all the other content that we're putting up onto the channel. So as I said before, thank you for getting involved. If you're not already subscribed, please do make sure you're hitting that subscribe button at the bottom of the page and getting involved, man. I want to see more people getting involved. Obviously, we're here to review as many different styles of music as we can, including this new one from M Huncho and Nafe Smalls. It is Thursday evening, which means we are running through loads of new reactions throughout the course of the day. So yeah, please stay tuned to the channel. About this one, it was announced last week, and we've seen a couple of previews for it dropping left, right, and center. The video looks very exciting indeed, so I am very keen to get into this one. M Huncho has been on a crazy roll this year, and Nafe Smalls is obviously very notorious in what he does, being a very kind of slick vocalist. And as I said, M Huncho has been on a real roll this year, so I'm looking forward to seeing how they come together. I believe this is part of an EP project that they are putting together as well, so we're going to get into this one now. But one thing I do have to say before we get into the video is there will be a lot of pausing on this video. It's the only way I've managed to be able to find in which the videos don't get copyrighted and taken down. It also means we're analyzing the videos start to finish. So if you're not very keen on watching a lot of pauses, if you're not very keen on listening into quite in-depth analysis, this probably won't be a video for you. However, please do stick around if you want to hear some in-depth analysis, because that's what we do here on Cub Reacts. Let's crack on. Looking forward to this one. We are here for the premiere, as we always try to be. So I'm excited for this. This is already looking spicy. Mate, what's the budget on this video?
Evacuate immediately. Evacuate immediately.
That looks so sick. Right, here we go. We are off, people. We are off. As I said before, there will be a lot of pauses, so be aware.
Money made a change, but it never changed us.
Nice.
Go keep going, you know. Wow.
Very spacey intro so far, sounding a little bit quite American influenced by the sounds of things, quite ATL sort of sounding from what I gathered so far. I'm looking forward to seeing this one drop. Let's go.
Money made a change, but it never changed me. I can tell you that for free. Diamonds Tel Aviv, go from Tel Aviv, fucking go to sleep, fucking go to sleep.
I like the fact there's the delay on the sub notes coming in underneath, because that really emphasizes the kind of vocal melody that they're going with. And then you are kind of waiting for it. You're kind of there going, come on, subs have got a roll. And they do come in almost, I think, 3.5 bars in. They start to drop in. Nice.
You can take a look. You can't have a peek. Help my brothers out. Help them people breathe. Just so they can speak, just so they can talk, just so they can hear.
Again, as we can hear, quite American influenced on this, but I'm not mad at it at all. I like the fact that we're hearing a lot more of this kind of very auto-tune heavy vocal work from a lot of UK artists, because I think it sounds cool, you know. I think I don't understand people that are out here like, oh, he's using auto-tune, it's just I don't like it because it's auto-tune. Grow up, stop being dusty. There's nothing wrong with auto-tune. It's basically turning your voice into a new style of instrument. That's all it is.
Money on my wrist, take a look at this. When I bought a crib, then I bought an X. Now I wanna flex, now they wanna drift.
Is one in slow motion and the other one not? That's quite a cool effect. I've never actually seen that.
I just took a leak, cash over pussy, money, Marilini,
yeah. The pack goes like Houdini, yeah. I was broke, yeah. To get where I'm worth easy, yeah.
So it looks like we're going for a bit of back and forth, a bit of a back to almost like a call and respond between the two of them. I do like that effect where one's in slow motion and one's not, because it looks like it's done on the same shot. Very clever camera work. And overall, the sound of this one so far, I think it's in a similar vein to what I would have expected, seeing M Huncho and Nafe Smalls link up again. Very auto-tuned on the vocals, but they do come with sort of different vocal tones within that auto-tune as well. So there's a nice differentiation between the two verses.
All of that ice is freezing. She knows it's steam. Smoking that blood, no.
Again, nice kind of vocal expressions going on as well, really utilizing that auto-tune and kind of hitting these pitches and notes that sound really, really cool in the auto-tune sort of sound. I mean, when you really, really push like a harder sounding vocal, there's a slight distortion that happens with an auto-tune, and I think it sounds so cool when it does. And again, what is the budget on this video? It's looking very, very crispy so far. We saw the intro look crazy, saw the big warehouse space. We're now looking at quite like a plush looking apartment place. So it's It's big money.
Looking for my papa, switching sides. I never switch for the karma. Do the time. I never snitch on my blood.
Yeah, this video is looking cool, man. I like the layout of it. And again, we're getting another sped up effect here by the looks of things.
Ain't cheap, but I ain't copping. Now this shit was free. They be calling fouls out in the field. They ain't no referee.
So it's, you know what it is? It's not the most sing-along catchy type of tune, but it's definitely a tune that you could bump while driving. I definitely think this is a driver's tune. It's one you're going to be playing whilst you're driving around and getting on with your day, doing whatever. But yeah, it's cool. I don't think it's the best I've heard from either of them so far, but I do think there's elements of it that I do really enjoy. I like the fact they're pushing the auto-tune and there is the call and response sort of stuff going on as well.
We come from the bomb, from the muddy.
How much of a similarity is there between Young Ads and Nave Smalls? I feel they've got quite a similar sort of vocal reach and they're in a similar kind of region and they have a similar performance style. Obviously, there's differences. I'm not saying they're the same, obviously. Don't be silly. But I do feel they've got a lot of kind of similarities in the way they project, which isn't a bad thing. It's clearly a style that works and people are interested in. But I've just kind of clocked that right now. But they have got quite similar styles.
I get on my weed flowing from Cali, from overseas.
Again, that nice transition between the two verses. I'm not quite sure what the structure is. It almost sounds like there was an intro sort of 16, then a 32, I think it was, from Nave Smalls, and now we're back on M Huncho. So I don't know if it's just them rolling out in the entirety. What we're seeing more and more and more now in UK music is moving away from the kind of typical sort of verse chorus bridge chorus structure, which is so like common in music being released, especially in kind of in popular music now. But I quite like the fact we're seeing more of these kind of essentially rally tunes, but just with two people, and the way they're kind of put together, kind of really moving away from the norm and the conventional means of composition, which sounds really, really cool.
This shit's easy, yeah. Left the country for a meeting, yeah. And I got a two-tone, no, and I'm really into timekeeping, yeah.
Nice little subtle flex there, talking about the watch. Very nice. I won't lie, people. I've owned about 5 watches in my life, and I've never used one to tell the time. I don't even bother wearing a watch anymore. You can see I just don't really see the point. But that's me, you know. Do what you want to do in life. Quick note on the instrumental structure on this as well. Very nicely produced, very subtle. Those 808 tones are quite clunky, but they're clunky on purpose because it gives the whole thing a sort of natural dip and a natural kind of groove. However, there isn't really much going on above it, which is giving both M Huncho and Nave Smalls a lot of space to kind of use their vocal tones. There's not really much going on in the high end of the instrumental from what I've heard so far. Something might leap out at me now I've said that, but it sounds like it's very kind of distant in the mid range and low end, and that's what's really allowing both vocalists to like do what they want to do.
Don't step in the bando with no money, cause this isn't free. Came from public housing, man, this come up, yeah, it isn't easy. Had to pay accountants, this shit wasn't cheap.
Don't talk to me about taxes, people. Don't talk to me about taxes. Don't talk to me about HMRC either. if you've got enough to pay an accountant, I back you. It's a stress if you can't afford an accountant, bro. Trust me.
Had money in my sock, I'm ducking from the D's.
Nice switch around on the flow there as well. That was one thing I was going to be critical of on this. There wasn't much kind of differentiating in the flow patterns. However, that little switch up there was exactly what it was crying out for. It was almost like a slight steer in a different direction, which re-emerges your ears. Re-announces the tune to your ears, sorry. And it's a nice switch up and very much needed.
Made it from the dirt, you can't apprehend, you cannot relate. Staying up too late, sacrifice the fame just to catch a break.
That's a bit of real talk there as well. If you are trying to chase this life, bro, I'm not gonna lie, if you're trying to chase kind of a music full-time sort of scenario, you are staying up late, and if you want to catch a break, you are and you want to get a bit of time away, you are going to be sacrificing fame to do that. Nice little input there. There's been a couple of nice little bars in there from M Huncho, and I feel this isn't really a tune that's about bars. It's about how it sounds. It's about the sing-along factor, so to sneak a couple in is quite cool.
Money made a change, but it never changed me. I can tell you that yeah. For free. Diamonds Tel Aviv, go from Tel Aviv, fucking go to sleep.
Again, and this is now the callback to that chorus at the start of the tune. So it's almost like bringing the tune full circle. Nice, it's almost like encapsulated within those two verses, with the chorus block either side. Nice way to kind of round things off, I think.
You can't take a look, you can't have a peek. Help my brothers out, help them people breathe.
just so they can sneak.
Do you know what I've always wondered in these music videos as well? Do they hire the money? Is it fake money, or have they just taken the money out of an account? I mean, how can you hire money? Thinking about that, what a stupid thing to say. But do you reckon there's like a place you can get like replica money for music videos? Because I mean, maybe it's just me. Maybe I'm a bit tighter than I thought I was, but I wouldn't have thought I would ever want to go to a music video with a stack of my own money just to throw it around. Maybe that's just me though.
Just so they can talk, just so they can hiss. Money on my wrist, take a look at this when I bought a crib. Then I bought an X, now I wanna flex, now they wanna drift.
It's sounding really, really cool, man. The general arrangement, general layout of the tune, solid. And again, I quite like that kind of almost like cased in structure where you've got the start, you've got the tune basically lodged in between two chorus blocks rather than going verse, chorus, bridge, chorus, as I was saying earlier. It's a nice kind of alternation on a very classic kind of industry style.
I just took a leak, cash over pussy, money married me.
And then we get the bridge. And you can hear we get this kind of more sort of floaty, kind of atmospheric, very almost OVO sounding kind of bridge at the end of the tune, just to kind of filter everything out. It's a nice way of structuring it. There we go. And one last pause at the end, just to annoy the people that don't like pauses and to make sure I don't get copyrighted. Okay. So we're now throwing back to the scene at the beginning. What on earth is going on here? Oh. Nice. Very nice way to outro the tune. I've got to say, I'm impressed with this one, and the reason I'm impressed is the sort of style of instrumental and style of vocal on this one aren't necessarily the things that I leap out of bed for, but the way they've approached it and the way they've kind of mashed it together and they've kind of played around with structure and they've played around with general layout has me interested. So I like the way they've kind of put it together. They've used a kind of very modernized, quite a common style now, I feel, of using auto-tune. They've used it just as a kind of additional instrument, but then they've added these extra kind of pushes vocally, and they've added these kind of little riffs in there, and then obviously played around with the structure to make it interesting to listen to. So I've got to say, fair play. This one, 5 a.m. M Hunt Show and Nave Smalls, and I believe this is the lead track off their new EP, which I think is most likely going to be dropping this evening. I don't know that for certain though, so do double check. If you have enjoyed this video, please do make sure that you are subscribing to the channel. We want to hit as many new subs as possible. We've gone up 300 today, so I hope we're doing something right, people, and I hope you have enjoyed this analytical breakdown. And again, I do apologize for the amount of pauses. I wish it could be another way, but until I'm whitelisted, I can't really see a way around it, if I'm being completely honest. Make sure you're following me on socials as well, @CubKXVU on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and SoundCloud. And we shall see you next time, people. Peace.